Okay, so we just finished step number 10, which was basting the exterior and lining panels together. Now we are going to, for step 11, we're going to mark the centers. So you'll use the pattern pieces. Here's the gusset pattern piece. You would line this up and make a mark on the center. I have my line of stitching there, so I'm not going to mark it. And then on the end, I made a center line for marking this. So just mark the center. And you can mark on the lining side or the exterior, whatever works for you. Just make sure you keep it in the seam allowance, because you don't want it to be on the exterior of your bag. It's a little harder to mark that part with the handle in the way. All right. And then on the main panels, one of your centers will be the center of the zipper. And the other center, you'll just use this pattern piece. Line it up with the bottom. And the sides and that curve, and then make that mark there in the center, and then on the other side as well. All right, and sometimes I check to make sure, you know, when I flip it over, that that's still the center, that I didn't have something off a little bit. Because I have done it before where I've somehow mismarked it, and then you get everything all pinned together and it looks weird and you can't figure out why, and here it's because you marked your centers wrong. Okay. So now that I have the centers marked, you will. Clips are preferable for this, for sure. Rather than pins. They're much easier to work with. Let's get a bunch out here. Okay. So the very first step in attaching these together, so this would be step 12, you'll want to place the right side, the exterior sides together. And I'm going to take that center mark I made right there and center it over the zipper, right in the center of the zipper, match up that line. And I'll go ahead and clip that. Just put one clip right there in the center. And then on the other side, you'll kind of pop that up. And you'll want to find that same center mark on the end and match it up with the center of the zipper. And once they're matched up, just clip that in place. Okay. Once you have those matched, then you're going to match the bottom center of the gusset. Oh, I've got my stuff fraying here. I laid this on the floor earlier to take a picture of it that I posted on Instagram. And now there's dog hair on everything, more than there was before. So apparently I need to sweep. And the dog doesn't even come out here, so it's just kind of crazy. Okay, so now I have my center mark here, which is my line of stitching, and I'll mark it, or I'll match it up with the center line on the bottom of the main panel. Pin, clip that. I guess I always say pin that, but really you're clipping it. Okay, and then same thing here. And just match that center and clip that. I like these clips better. Okay, so once I have those clipped, then I will work my way around. If you read through the pattern first, you'll see that I recommend sewing this portion of it with this side up. So I'm going to face my clips in that direction because, like I said, I'm weird like that. But also, that's going to tell me about how far I need to keep that side facing up when I stitch around that. So I usually do like halfway. I'll show you once I get this flipped. And I just kind of work my way between, you know, clipping along the bottom and clipping up the sides and around the curves until I get everything in place. And I think this is one of those instances where more clips are better just to hold everything. Try to keep my lining from bunching up there. You know, and I actually had a thought with the using that fusible webbing, the heat and brown light. If you put it on both sides of your foam, you could just iron that lining right down to it too, and the inside would be really smooth and perfect. So this part takes me a while. I don't know if you guys want to watch me pin the whole thing or clip it. I'll continue to say pin even though I'm clipping, just because that's what I say. And you want to, when you pin it, you'll notice, or clip it, whatever, you will notice that, like, right up on the edges, you see that you have these, like, wrinkles there. You'll have that when you ease it together, because the edges are not the part that matches up. Half an inch down in here, where the seam line is, that's the part that matches, and there you won't have wrinkles, or you shouldn't have, and if you do, you know, readjust a little bit until you don't. So the edges won't always match up perfectly in curves. They won't ever really, they shouldn't. And that's fine because that's not the part that needs to match. What needs to match is 1/2 inch in, which is your seam line. We'll see after the video if any of you feel better about binding inside the bag. I know that a lot of people say they don't like it, or you know, it's not their favorite, or maybe they just don't feel like they're that good at it. And honestly, I can say that it is not. I don't like these red clips that much. Binding is not my very favorite thing to do. It's my favorite look, I guess, the way the inside of the bag looks. You don't get a saggy lining. Everything looks nice and crisp on the inside. That, I love that about binding. So, even though it's not my favorite thing to do, it's probably one of my favorite ways to finish a bag. Just because I feel like the finished product looks so nice. Try to work and make sure that there's no puckers down there in that seam line right now, just so that way when I get done, I'm not having to rip stitches out and fix them, even if it's only tiny spots. I mean, I'd rather not. The seam ripper's not my favorite. Okay, so I have that side all clipped. I'll make sure that as I sew this, I'm not getting any wrinkles under there, and now I'll go clip around the other side. It's easier for me this way. So again, if you don't have clips, I don't know, I guess I don't know how Amazon is, like if you're not in the United States, I don't know that it's, you know, as cheap of an option, but I think like eBay maybe, I don't know. But I will find these clips that I have that I bought off Amazon. They were very inexpensive and they're the best thing ever. So I will link those, because that really helps too, not only with this, but with the binding. But I think it's more helpful when you're sewing anything with foam. It's a lot easier than pinning. And I have used binder clips too in the past, and those hold, they hold really well. My only issue with those was after, you know, going around something like this where you're using that many of them, they would hurt my fingers. Now see how sometimes when I clip them on, what can you see? I got them pretty. Okay, when I clip them on, sometimes the lining, the edge of the lining fabric kind of wants to curl under, so just be careful to keep an eye on that and make sure that you're not folding any of that over where it's going to stick out after you've sewn. And I did think actually too that it would be helpful after you baste your lining, or when you're basting your lining maybe to the exterior, if like if I was using my domestic machine anyway, if you did a zigzag stitch all the way around, that would hold those edges down so that it wasn't puckering like that. Or not puckering, I don't know, that the end of the raw edge of the side will fold down like this away from the foam. So if it was zigzag stitched, it wouldn't do that. Okay, this has got to be the most boring video. So hopefully if it is, at least there's something I'm doing that you're seeing that's helpful, or I don't know. Last time I kept saying I need to play music. Maybe I should do that. Have some music at least in the background. Not laying right for me. Try again. Okay. Well, I'm probably blocking most of your view with my arm here. One of my favorite things, this just made me think of the way I was grabbing that, to use in sewing that I haven't been able to find since I moved my sewing room, are tweezers. And I use those a lot, like while I'm sewing, even once I have to remove the clip to just hold things together, I'll grab them with my tweezers. I need to look for those or buy another pair. All right, so we have it all clipped all the way around. I also want to add, I don't know if you noticed, but I didn't say anything. I opened my zipper up before I did this. You want to do that, otherwise you're going to sew all the way around and your zipper's going to be closed and it's not going to be easy to open. All right. So now to sew this. We are on... this would be step 15. Well, I guess 14. Step 14 is showing you which area I sew from this side. Let's see if you can see that. Okay. No, you can't see anything really. It's too tall. Okay. So one portion of it I sew with this side up. This is the end. And then for the other parts, I will sew like this, with the main panel up. So if you look at step 14, it kind of gives you marks that are about midway on the end panels, which are kind of marked by the direction I have the pins or the clips here. These ones are facing up towards us. That's the area that I sew from that side. So step 15, you will sew with the gusset facing up. So the gusset will be against your presser foot. The main panel is down on the bed of your machine. And don't be afraid to squish your bag up and get it under there. You'll press it when you're done. Sometimes you need to squish things to get it out of your way. Alright, so I'm going to slide that under the presser foot, and we're using a 1/2 inch seam allowance here. Make sure you backstitch. See, and this is another instance. This is where I would use my tweezers to kind of hold things together. So I'm going to have to find those. If you haven't watched my other videos, you probably haven't seen this, but this little screwdriver here, I use all the time. It's not actually, I mean, I use it to change my needles and stuff, but I'll use it to kind of hold things in place under the foot as I go. So it's just important here to take your time and readjust things as necessary. Make sure you always stop with your needle down so that things aren't shifting on you. You will be sewing over zipper teeth at one end, which is actually the other end. So at that point when you sew over those zipper teeth, just be careful. Knowing that you're sewing over, especially if you used a metal zipper, just use caution when you're doing that. Hand crank it. You don't want to break a needle. So I'm curious also, do you guys enjoy watching these videos? Because I don't usually rewatch my own video back before I post it. I literally just hit stop and I upload them. I don't watch them. I mean, I probably should edit my videos. Maybe someday. Right now I'm just trying to do it to help anybody out if I can. I'm not a videographer. Is that the right phrase or right term that I would use? Alright. Cut the threads. Nope, I don't. Make sure you don't have any puckers. Like I have one right there. I don't know if you see that. Honestly, if it's not on the outside, I might just leave it. We'll see. I'm going to finish everything and then I'll flip it to see if there are puckers on the other side. So if you can see this, I only sewed around this portion of the bag. Nope, you can't see that. Why does it zoom in so much when it's... Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. This video is actually not even at the right angle that I want it to be. Okay. So I just sewed here. Now I'm questioning if I should stop the video. I'm going to stop it and then I'll start a new one horizontal, but this is going to have to go in there so that I don't have to redo all that.